of us as having like kind of two main kind of areas that we're responsible for. So one is the production pipeline. That's the code that runs every day, produces trades or whatever other model outputs we need. The other aspect that we focus on is the research platform. And that is a bunch of code that makes it easy for researchers to do what they need to do. Get data, transform that data, do some sort of fitting process, run a back test or simulation, analyze the results of that back test. The goal there is to make the research process as efficient and productive as possible. You can have the smartest researchers in the world, but if they can't actually test their ideas, they just won't make any progress. And so that's what we do as the QD team. It is about understanding the business, understanding the economics of what we're doing, and understanding the numbers that our code is producing at a level that allows you to make good decisions about what we're doing. Did I implement this thing correctly? Is this the most efficient way of calculating this thing? Maybe there's some shortcut we can take, maybe some unrelated number in the system that we can compare this to, cross-check it, make sure it's good. It's also an engineering job. We are writing code, we are building systems, we're solving, you know, complex engineering questions that go hand in hand with these more numerical kind of like economic questions of what are we computing. I think another really cool thing about the work that we do here is like everything we do is connected to a business outcome. There's a lot of cases, you know, in the industry, in big tech, where, you know, people work on projects that are like, you know, science projects or, you know, things that ultimately don't end up going anywhere. That is anathema to us. There's so many important problems to solve. We cannot afford to have people, you know, spend time on things that don't ultimately pay out, right? Even just, let's talk about like the production reliability aspect, right? Let's say we get some bad data from a vendor. What do we do? What's the right thing to do? Should we use yesterday's value? Should we use a different vendor? Should we use a synthetic value derived from other things? Should we require human intervention? This is what makes our business. Getting those details right is the difference between a competitive systematic business and one that doesn't make money. There's just so many opportunities for people, for individuals to stretch into new roles, to try new things. We think about what is your potential, what types of new problems can you solve? We give people new problems, things they haven't done before, things they're not experts in, and we say, you know, we think you can figure it out, let's give it a try.